Hello everyone, I'm back and I'm going to make another geode on a larger canvas than the last one I did. This is a canvas of 60 by 80 centimeters and I primed my canvas with two layers of gesso and three layers of white acrylic paint. What you are seeing now at the moment is that I'm putting some gold leaf glue on the canvas. I already made my design with the pencil. I don't know if you can see it, but I already made it. And on the areas where I want a gold leaf, I put some special glue on it. After that, you need to let it dry for 10 minutes and then you can put the gold leaf on it. So we are 10 minutes later and now I can put the gold leaf on my canvas. So you need to handle it with a little bit of care because it's very thin and the paper on top of it is for that you don't damage the gold leaf. So I'm filling in the gap where I put the glue on. And with a spatula, I am pressing the gold leaf on the canvas, that it sticks on the glue. Also the sides. And you can also use the excess of the gold leaf to fill in some gaps, what you see me do now. But always use that paper, because otherwise you have all kind of scratches on your gold leaf, and that isn't nice. And this geode is gonna be in the colors gold, green, black and white. And a lot of glitter and crystals and crushed glass. But I need to do it in steps because it's a large canvas. And now the other side, filling in the gaps. Again, I'm using the paper. So, and with a very soft brush, you can brush the excess of the gold leaf away so that you get the shape that you glued. Going along the sides, very carefully, and there you have the shape that I want. Also the other side. And this is how I apply the gold leaf on a canvas. Also a little bit with my fingers, I'm putting down a gold leaf on my canvas, very carefully. So now it's time to put some color on the canvas. I'm starting with a Lerer Midnight Black, a very deep black color, and it's going to be all around the gold leaf. So a large part it's going to be black. It's already a little bit thicker, so that's better for a geode. And with my steering stick I'm pushing the resin to the place I want it to be. If the resin is a little bit thicker, then it doesn't flow to the sides that much, and I like that. And Mastercast is a little bit thicker than other resins, so that's ideal for making a geode, the way I do it. So what I already told you, that this geode is going to be in several videos, because it's a large canvas and I need to do this in steps, because some parts I don't want the colors to flow in each other. Now I'm putting some crushed glass on the canvas and I'm pushing it with my steering stick against the black. So it gets a little bit in the black, but it also stays a little bit on the gold leaf. So what I already said is this geode is going to be mainly gold, different golds, glitter gold, gold leaf, and some other gold I'm going to use, black, and also green, different shades of green, and white, and lots of glitter, and stones, and glass. So it's going to be very sparkly. And several layers to create some depth. Now, I hope I can create some depth. And the black stays nicely in shape. It doesn't flow that much to the sides. It's good. And the gold leaf at the moment looks a little bit flat, but I hope that I create some depth in it when I go ahead with this painting. So the last crushed glass on the canvas. Now some Racy Tint Plus Rich Gold, and I'm putting it on the side, outer side of the black, big dots and lines, and it's a very nice color, and you can make very special effects with this pigment. And I hope that it, when it's gonna get some heat, that it looks like it's floating on the black color and some cells maybe, because if you give it some heat, then it gets all kind of special effects. So all the way along the side. Now some clear over the gold leaf. And because of the clear, the gold leaf looks much more vibrant. So I'm pushing it carefully against the crushed glass. And if the black flows a little bit through the crushed glass into the clear, I don't mind. I like that. A little bit on top of the crushed glass, some clear. Now I'm adding some stones on the gold leaf and in the clear, because then you can create some depth and also some structure. If you leave it only gold leaf, then it's so flat. So that's why I'm adding some crushed glass. Not the whole area, but a few. And now some acrylic ink of Dalarani. I made it very transparent because I only want to create some depth and some contrast. Again, a black line. And I'm going to do it the same way as I did with the other black. I'm pushing the resin to the place I wanted with my stirring stick. And this is why it helps me, why I put the design first on with a pencil. Then I know where I put the colors or where I want them. And how big the lines should be. So that helps a lot. Again, some Resi-Tint Plus rich gold on the black. Now some heat on it, and yeah, then we need to wait and see what kind of special effects it gives us, because this pigment reacts a lot with heat. So over the gold leaf and the clear, also some heat for the air bubbles. So this was part one. If you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel, and I will see you next time. Bye.